Shanti Minikanti and Mrs. Haimavati take this opportunity to welcome you all to today's celebrations. It is indeed a new experience when our dear children and the esteemed parents are joining the celebrations virtually. On behalf of management, principal, vice principal and the staff of Bhavan Sri Ramakrishna Vidyalaya, I extend a warm welcome. We are glad to announce the arrival of our Honorary Director, Group Captain, retired Dhiram Naya. The guard of honor is given by our associate NCC officer, first officer N. Ramadevi, Army Wing, and third officer K. Rambabu, Air Force Wing. Sir is being escorted by our principal, Mrs. B. Jyoti Aparna, and vice principal, Dr. C. Srilata. I now request our Honorary Director, Group Captain, retired D. Ramanaya, to unfurl the national flag.
Salute! Order!
I now request our principal ma'am and vice principal ma'am to kindly escort sir to be seated among the audience. The national anthem was played by Mruga of 11th B. Thank you, Mruga. May the Indian tricolor always fly high, proud to be an Indian. Happy Republic Day. Freedom in mind, strength in the words, pride in our souls, zeal in our hearts. Let's salute our great country on its 72nd Republic Day. India is a country of diversity, bonded by love and affection. On this auspicious occasion of Republic Day, let us come together to celebrate this day with respect and love for each other. January 1950 was a historic day when the Constitution of India came into effect, thereby making India a sovereign republic. The date was selected because it was when Purna Swaraj was declared in 1930 by the Indian National Congress. This Republic Day is very significant as the nation is making a serious effort to cross some challenging phase, COVID-19. This time around, we want to sail through this because we know that there is a large possibility beyond it. Due to the discovery of Covaxin, which we hope will give back the unbridled, fear-free existence to mankind. We hope that it takes the effort of every one of us to get this nation across this pandemic. Due to the pandemic, since the school has not reopened for physical classes, it is on us teachers to celebrate this great day. Of course, we miss every moment the enthusiasm and participation of our dear children. Hope you all will enjoy watching this program live. India is a cradle of the human race, speech, the mother of history, the grandmother of legend, the great grandmother of tradition. The most valuable and the most artistic materials in the history of man are treasured up in India. Now I request Mrs. Deepa Shyam ma'am to share her thoughts on this auspicious day. Our Constitution is a ray of hope. H for harmony, O for opportunity, P for people's participation, and E for equality. Wish you all a happy Republic Day. Good morning, Director Sir, Principal Ma'am, Vice Principal Ma'am, dear children, esteemed parents present here, and who are watching virtually, and all my dear colleagues. I, Deepa Shyam, is here to share my thoughts on Republic Day. 26 January 1950 marked the triumph of people's will, aspirations for them as well as their motherland. The age-old shackles of foreign subjugation, exploitation, and persecution finally came to an end. India and Indians reigned supreme. The people's will was established with the drafting of the Constitution and its acceptance on 26 January 1950 and its enforcement, which declared India as a sovereign, democratic and republic country. Republic Day is a very important and special occasion for India and its citizens. Indians celebrate Republic Day every year on 26 January with lots of preparations. India is celebrating its 72nd Republic Day today. The occasion completed the country's long-required change towards becoming an independent republic country. It has been a long journey since its inception in 1950. There were many challenges: external aggression, internal threats, political upheavals, poverty, corruption, and what not. But India has always held her head high, rising to the occasion effectively. The Lokpal Bill, demonetization to fight corruption, surgical strike, Niti Aayog, enforcement of lockdown during corona pandemic in spite of expected economic setbacks, and with a huge population and plenty of challenges, we are almost successful in fighting against the COVID and are also putting a step ahead in administration of vaccine. Last but not the least, the new education policy. Our freedom was taken away from us, but because of the valiant struggles by the sons of the soil, we got it back. So let us all take a pledge to commit ourselves to the task of nation building. As teachers, it is our responsibility to infuse discipline in today's children to make them responsible citizens of tomorrow. Always cherish your independence and respect the supreme law of the land, the Constitution. I would like to conclude with this quote. Let every teacher teach the nation, teach the student how to love this nation. Let every parent instill in his or her sons and daughters the beauty of our nation. I repeat, let every teacher teach the student how to love this nation. Let every parent instill in his or her sons and daughters the beauty of our nation. I thank the management, principal and vice principal for giving me this opportunity. Jai Hind. Thank you, ma'am, for sharing your thoughts. Twenty-nine states, 1,618 languages, six major religions, six ethnic groups, one country. This shows that despite having diverse culture, traditions, languages, religions, we stand together as one. This shows our country believes in unity in diversity, and we are proud that we are Indians. To evoke the same spirit Here we have teachers from various wings coming together to present a patriotic song in Sanskrit written by Devulapalli Krishna Sastri. नमन नमन उस माँ को मेरा जिसकी गोद में पली बड़ी है हजारों पीढ़ियां। नमन उस भारत माँ को मेरा जो कहलाती है सोने की चिड़िया। थैंक यू टीचर्स फॉर प्रोजेक्टिंग द फील ऑफ पेट्रियोटिज्म अमोंग अस। आई नाउ रिक्वेस्ट मिसेस शांति सुहासिनी मैम टू शेयर हर व्यूज इन तेलुगु ऑन दिस रिपब्लिक डे। जय भारत जनयित्री वंदनम जय 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 दिव्य धात्री वंदनम श्रीरामुडु श्रीकृष्णुडु नीदु बिड्डलै वेलसिरी लोकुलकु धर्मबद्धमैन दारिनि चूपिंचिरी गौतमुडु महावीरुडु नीदु बिड्डलै कदम्मा అహింసయే పరమ ధర్మమనుచు భువిని ప్రవచించిరి రాణా ప్రతాప్ ఛత్రపతి రణధీరులు నీ బిడ్డలు నీ దాస్య శృంఖలములు తెంప కడవరకు పోరినారు రాణి రుద్రమా ఝాన్సీ రాజసంపు నీ దుహితలు విరోధులను మట్టి కుడిపి వీర జ్యోతులై వెలిగిరి జయ భారత జనయిత్రి వందనం జయ 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 దివ్యధాత్రి వందనం గౌరవనీయులైన శ్రీయుతులు డైరెక్టర్ గ్రూప్ కెప్టెన్ రిటైర్డ్ డి రమణయ్య గారికి ప్రిన్సిపల్ శ్రీమతి జ్యోతి అపర్ణ గారికి వైస్ ప్రిన్సిపల్ డాక్టర్ సి శ్రీలత గారికి వివిధ శాఖల ఇన్ఛార్జెస్ కి నా తోటి ఉపాధ్యాయ ఉపాధ్యాయుని బృందానికి సభకు విచ్చేసిన అతిథులకు తక్కిన పాఠశాల నిర్వాహకులందరికీ నమస్సుమాంజలులు అందరికి 72వ గణతంత్ర దినోత్సవ శుభాకాంక్షలు 1950 జనవరి 26వ తేదీన భారత రాజ్యాంగం అమలులోకి వచ్చింది కాబట్టి మనం ప్రతి సంవత్సరం జనవరి 26వ తేదీని గణతంత్ర దినోత్సవంగా జరుపుకుంటున్నాం మన రాజ్యాంగం డాక్టర్ భీమ్రావ్ అంబేద్కర్ నాయకత్వంలో రాజ్యాంగ కమిటీ ద్వారా తయారు చేయబడింది ఇది గత కాలపు వైభవం అయితే ఈనాడు భారతావని ప్రపంచ స్థాయిలో తిరుగులేని గుర్తింపును పొందింది దేశం అన్ని రంగాలలోనూ ముందంజలో ఉంది ఆధునిక వైజ్ఞానిక సాంకేతిక రంగంలో అద్భుతమైన ఆవిష్కరణలు జరుగుతున్నాయి అంతర్జాతీయ స్థాయిలో సత్యం నాదెళ్ళ సుందర పిచ్చయ్ అరవింద్ కృష్ణ సంతను నారాయణ్ ఇంద్రానోయి దినేష్ పాలివాల్ అజయ్ బాంగా వంటి బహుళ జాతి కంపెనీలకు సీఈఓలుగా పొందిన గుర్తింపు అనన్య సామాన్యం అప్రతిహతం మోక్షగుండం విశ్వేశ్వరయ్య కల్పనా చావ్లా ఏపీజే అబ్దుల్ కలాం మేఘనాథ్ సాహా సుబ్రహ్మణ్యం చంద్రశేఖర్ హర్వింద్ గోవింద్ ఖురానా ఎస్ఎస్ అభ్యాంకర్ వంటి శాస్త్రవేత్తలకు పుట్టినిల్లు మన భారతదేశం ప్రస్తుత యుఎన్ఓ శాశ్వత ప్రతినిధులుగా నియమింపబడ్డ టిఎస్ తిరుమూర్తి ఇందిరా పాండే భారత మాత మకటంలో అమర్చబడిన మణిరత్నాలే అంతెందుకు ఇప్పుడు ప్రపంచాన్ని అతలాకుతలం చేసి పట్టి పీడిస్తున్న కరోనా వైరస్ కి మన భాగ్యనగరంలో మందులు తయారు చేయబడడం సాంకేతిక రంగంలో ఎంత పురోభివృద్ధిని సాధించామో చెప్పడానికి ప్రబల నిదర్శనం లక్షల సంఖ్యలో వ్యాక్సిన్లు తయారు చేసి ప్రపంచ దేశాలకు అందిస్తోంది కరెక్ట్ గా సంవత్సరం క్రితం మాస్కులకు కూడా సిద్ధంగా లేని స్థితి నుండి ప్రపంచానికే వ్యాక్సిన్ ఇచ్చే స్థాయికి ఎదిగింది మన దేశం ఎప్పటికీ విశ్వగురువే ఏ నాటికి మార్గదర్శే ఇక ప్రస్తుతానికి వస్తే ఈనాడు నా ఎదుట ప్రేక్షకులుగా నిలిచిన సమూహం సామాన్యమైనది కాదు అధ్యాపక వృత్తిని చేపట్టిన భావి భారత రూప శిల్పులు ఒకవైపు అంతర్జాతీయ స్థాయిలో వైద్యులు నర్సులు కరోనా మహమ్మారితో పారద్రోలడానికి తలమునకలై ఉంటే మరోవైపు అధ్యాపకులు భావి తరాల రూపురేఖలను తీర్చిదిద్దడంలో అలుపెరగని కృషి చేయడం హర్షణీయం ఈ మేధావి వర్గానికి గణతంత్ర దినోత్సవ విశేషాలను వివరించడం పగటి పూట దివిటీలు వెలిగించినట్లేనని నా అభిప్రాయం ఎందరో వీరుల త్యాగఫలం విజ్ఞాన శోధన పటిష్ట ప్రణాళిక ఆవిష్కరణలు నేటి మన నిశ్చింత మనుగడకు పునాదులు ఈ పటిష్ట పునాదులపై ఊపిరి పోసుకున్న చిరంజీవులను కర్తవ్యోన్ముఖులను గావించడమే మన లక్ష్యం అసలు జీవితమే ఒక పోరాటం పరాయి పాలన నుండి విముక్తికై చేసిన పోరాటంతో మనుగడ ఆగిపోదు ఆనాడు మన పూర్వీకుల ముందు ఉన్న సమస్య విదేశీ పాలన ఒక్కటే అయితే ఈనాడు మన ముందు నిలిచిన సమస్యలు కోకొల్లలు సాధించిన విజయాలు చూసుకుని మురిసిపోయే సందర్భాల కన్నా ఉన్న సమస్యలపై మన దృష్టిని సారించి సమస్య పరిష్కార మార్గాల వైపు మరల్చగలిగే స్ఫూర్తిని మనం మన విద్యార్థులకు అందించగలగాలి 130 కోట్ల జనాభాతో పూర్ణ కుంభాన్ని తలపించే మన భారతం విభిన్న సమస్యలతో కుతకుతలాడుతున్న అన్న భాండంగా దర్శనమిస్తోంది నిండుగా సుష్టుగా ఆరగిద్దామని ఎదురు చూసినా అందరి కడుపుల ఆకలిని తీర్చగలిగే స్థితికి మనం ఇంకా చేరుకోలేదు ప్రజల కన్నీటి గాథలు గుండెలు పిండేసే ఘట్టాలు
हृदय विदारक हिंसात्मक राजकीय कुट्रलु कुलमताल हेच्चुतग्गुलु स्थायी भेदालु वंटि समस्यलतो शलभाले कालिपोतू छिद्रमैन बतुकुलु एन्नो एन्नेन्नो इदि नित्य रणरंगं कनुक అలుపెరగని పోరాటం అనివార్యం. అపారమైన వనరులున్న దుర్వినియోగం చేస్తూ నిర్లక్ష్య వైఖరితో ప్రవర్తించే వారికి చరమ గీతం పాడి సమర్థులై కార్యదక్షులై వెలుగొందే ప్రాజ్ఞులకు పట్టం కట్టగలిగితే మనం కలలుగన్న నవభారతం సుసాధ్యమవుతుంది. ఇది ఒక ఉపఖండంగా అలదారే ఈ భారత భూమికి సేవ చేయడానికి ఏ ఒక్క అబ్దుల్ కలామో, ఒక విక్రమ్భాయ్ సారాభాయో, ఒక సచిన్ టెండూల్కరో సరిపోరు. అటువంటి వారు కొన్ని వేల సంఖ్యలో తయారు కావాలి, కొన్ని లక్షల మంది పుట్టుకురావాలి. ఓ భావి భారత శిల్పులారా, అటువంటి కార్య సాధకులను కార్యదక్షులను తయారు చేసే మేధా సంపత్తికి చిరునామా మీరు. అజ్ఞానమనే అంధకారాన్ని పారద్రోలి జ్ఞానమనే వెలుగును ప్రసాదించే గురువులకు ఉన్నత స్థానాన్ని, ప్రథమ పీఠాన్ని స్థాపించిన మన భారతావనిలో విజయ ఘంటికలను మ్రోగించాలి. వార్షిక ప్రణాళికలలో వేసుకున్న మైలురాళ్లను సునాయాసంగా దాటగలిగే సత్తా మన యువతకు అందించే బాధ్యత మనందరిది. ఇదే ఈ సందర్భంలో నాకు మీకు ఇవ్వాలనిపించే సందేశం. జై హింద్. ధన్యవాదాలు.
థ్యాంక్ యూ మ్యామ్ ఫర్ షేరింగ్ యువర్ థాట్స్ అండ్ వ్యూస్ విత్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ అస్. ఈ నఫరత్ బురీ హే, నా పాలో ఇసే, दिलों में कलेश है, निकालो इसे. न इसका न उसका, न तेरा न मेरा, ये वतन है हम सबका, बचा लो इसे. Thousands laid down their lives so that our country breathes this day. We never forget their sacrifices. To honor the great personalities and heroes of India today, I welcome our primary wing teachers to present their dance based on the similar theme.
Thank you.
दोस्तों जिस तरीके से सड़क पर हमारे सैनिक वीर सैनिक डटे हुए हैं हमारी सुरक्षा के लिए, ठीक उसी प्रकार से इस कोरोना रूपी महामारी में कुछ ऐसे योद्धा हुए हैं जिन्होंने अपने जीवन और अपने परिवार की परवाह किए बिना ही रात दिन हमारी सेवा में डटे रहे। ऐसे वीर योद्धाओं को हम सहृदय से आभार प्रकट करते हैं, उन्हें नमन करते हैं और उन्हें सच नमन करते हैं और धन्यवाद। Conducted by Central Board of Secondary Education, New Delhi. These certificates are signed by Shri H. N. Dastoor, Executive Secretary, Bharati Vidya Bhavan, and Shri Rakesh Saxena, Director, Shikshan Bharati. It gives us an immense pleasure in announcing that this year, 12 students from our school are on that mark and shall be rewarded respectively. I now respect our Honorary Director, Group Captain, retired D. Ramnaya, to kindly do the honors. Sir will be escorted by our Principal, Mrs. B. Jyoti Aparna, and Vice Principal, Dr. C. Srilata, to the podium. As I call upon the names of the awardees, I request them to come and receive their certificates from our Honorary Director, Sir. The first awardee, Anika K. Next we have Meghna Helder. On behalf of her, her father is collecting the reward, the certificate. Next we have Varsha B. Shreya Sai. Saminevi Adya. Jnana Teja Kumaragiri. Ronnie Sebastian George. Shanak Dev Mishra.
Shanak is there.
P. Janavi. Next we have K. Srinidhi. Annapurna Ramaswamy. And P. Pranavi. Thank you, sir. I congratulate and appreciate all merited students and their parents who have put faith, hope and love together and have raised a positive person in society. I now request our honorary director, Group Captain Retired D. Ramnaya, to address the gathering.
Good morning to every one of you. Principal Srimati Jyoti Aparna, Vice Principal Dr. Sri Lata, faculty member, staff, students, though they are not physically not present here, I am sure now, with the principal's arrangement of online live screening, I hope they will be able to see us and hear guests. Let me wish you a very happy 72nd Independence Day, I mean rather Republic Day. Though I am saying happy, I am doing it with a very heavy heart, because the students who are supposed to be in the main stay in this type of a celebration, they are missing. This online, though they can see, it cannot substitute for their physical presence here. I just wonder, in a matter of 1 year, how this pandemic has changed our lifestyle. Totally. Put us into such a situation which we have never imagined. A school without students, classrooms without students, grounds without players, even platforms without practicing students. It is really, I could not reconcile, but all the same, this is the reality. Many of the schools have been asked to reduce staff because the students are not there. And even asked them to take a cut on their salaries, and which you have seen it in the paper, many of the schools have gone through that kind of a thing. At least here, our principal really fought with the management and ensured that not even a single teacher has been reduced. All this credit goes to the principal, who has ensured that all the teaching staff remain. And not only that, even she has gone to the extent of even class 4 contract employees who have been reduced to 50% pay, and she mobilized funds to feed them, which is really great work. I really appreciate her sympathetic for the philanthropic attitude, which really shows her concern to her staff and their welfare. And coming to the main issue of this pandemic, which has shaken not only our nation, the whole world. You have seen lockdown conditions, where the workers have to leave their jobs and migrate back to their villages, and the kind of suffering they have gone through. It is unimaginable. And not only this, even go into the extent of their livelihood and their suffering, which is we cannot even describe some conditions, the way they have left their jobs and gone away to their villages. And all this because the pandemic has been thrown over the world just because one evil force ambition. That is what happens in the past also, even in the Second World War. It is well known that no country is supposed to do the chemical and biological warfare materials which should not be used, and they are signatory to this. Yet, this biological experiment has thrown out the virus which was not able to be controlled by their own people. And at least it has been known to the world a little early. The other countries of the world would have taken care of it. That is what WHO could not warn the world that this is likely to come. By the time they announced, it is too late. Even till today, the WHO team, which want to investigate the virus origin, genesis, they are not even given visa in the beginning. Now, having taken the visa, they are not allowed into the labs there to find out how it has started. And you can well imagine that is a kind of the force which was doing this. We have suffered enough. You know how much of its expansionism caused the problem to us. And our Prime Minister had to take a very, very strategic step to contain. And he had done so because of the nature of attitude of this force has started expanding in your own borders and also in the seas, and you had to form a strategic quad. You know, understand that quad is the four countries coming together: India, Japan, Australia, and America. So this is the kind of a strategy with which he is trying to contend. Now, thanks for his wisdom. Today we are much better off from the acts of the one nation, how they wanted to control the others. It is nothing but what you call showing their superiority over others. That is what happened in Second World War also. Hitler was trying to do that. Now, as our speaker earlier in Telugu has said, we have got many more challenges to face. I am sure we have the talent, we have the capacity to face them. Today you see our talent, apart from what he said about the achievements of so many achievers. Even the recent American President Biden's administration has got more than 20 of Indians in their administration, where the Indians excelled in their field, and American President has chosen them. We have no lack of talent, lack of skill. I am sure now we can really progress with our Atmanirbhar program, which PM is now encouraging us to do. In spite of all this, despite all the problems, I am very happy to say our school has got a number of awards from the other organizations, which I am sure now she can show it, but the other day she could not go for one award, which I feel sorry for it. Now she could not physically receive it, but all the same, the award was given to school. And all those parents who are, whose wards are here, we can appreciate how much of appreciation as school has got. So with these few words, I wish every staff all the best and their continued support to bring the school on the top of the others. With these few words, I wish you good luck and God bless. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for sharing your valuable thoughts to the audience, and I'm sure that they enjoy listening to your inspiring words. I request our Vice Principal Ma'am, Dr. C. Srilata, to escort sir to be seated. I now request our Principal Ma'am, Mrs. B. Jyoti Aparna, to deliver the vote of thanks.
My proud privilege to propose the vote of thanks on the 72nd Republic Day. At the outset, let me wish you all a very happy Republic Day. This day, our constitution came into effect in 1950 and we declared ourselves sovereign, socialist and republic. This year is probably the first ever celebration without much pomp and show, the reason being very obvious: the corona pandemic. In spite of the difficult times, the world has been trying hard to get over the difficult situation. We too, at BSRKV have not left any stone unturned in trying our best to rise up to the occasion. This pandemic, though made many of our lives miserable, people losing their jobs and economies coming to a grinding halt, has taught us many things. People have taken this as an opportunity to explore and learn new things and reinvent their potentials. However, let me reiterate the precautions to be taken, like washing our hands frequently with soap and water, maintaining physical distance, sanitizing our surroundings frequently, and avoiding public places. I take this opportunity to congratulate four students who have made it to the finals in the Yuva Sangharsh 2021 conducted by Vivekananda Institute of Human Excellence, Ramakrishna Math, Hyderabad. I wish them all good luck for the final round. I also congratulate 12 of the class 10 students for their performance in CBSE board examinations and for receiving commendation certificates from BBB Mumbai. I am also very proud to announce that the school has received a few awards from Education Today and Education World, and also we have received a Pancharatna Award from our BBB Dimdima Wing. So I am very, very thankful to all the staff and my management for being with us, and also I thank the parents for being with us in order to help us achieving this. On behalf of the staff of BSRKV and my personal behalf, I would like to thank our Honorary Director, Group Captain D. Ramanaya sir, for gracing the occasion. Sir, we are obliged to you for giving your precious time and valuable message. I take this opportunity to thank the staff for the speech, song and the dance in today's program. I must take this opportunity to thank our parents for being with us during these difficult times. I would like to thank all the students for watching today's program live. I thank all the support staff for their help in making the program a grand success. Last but not the least, I thank everyone for making the day successful. Jai Hind.
Thank you, ma'am. The tricolor flutters majestically. The three colors on our national flag, saffron, white and green, symbolizes sacrifice of the million who died fighting for it, and peace and prosperity that prevails in our nation. It reminds of our responsibility that we have towards our nation. Happy Republic Day. Jai Hind. I request the choir led by Mrs. Lakshmi Bharati to come on stage for the national anthem.
I have a good point.